Hello everyone and welcome to another Homebrew update. I'm your host Troy, and this week we are actually only going to be talking about one company, not Nintendo, not Microsoft, but Sony. We don't have any other consoles to talk about, so let's just go ahead and get started. We're going to be talking about the PS Vita, the PS3, and the PS4. To start things off, we're going to be talking about something amazing on the PS Vita. The popular developer, The Flow, has been working on to get Henkaku, Taihen, whatever you want to call it, onto 3.65 firmware and above. Well guys, he actually said that he was able to get it on 3.65 and people will be able to use it, but there is one big catch to it. The catch is you will actually have to have a 3.60 console already, so one that's already able to be hacked, and then you can update to 3.65 and still keep your hacked firmware. This essentially just allows us so you can play higher firmware games that you can't play on 3.60. He did say this will be released sometime in the near future. I want to probably say maybe the end of this month or next month, sometime in the near future. I don't know exactly when, but it's still really cool. One minor thing is if you do accidentally say update to 3.67 or reformat your device or something like that, unfortunately, you will lose the hack and you will have to wait until The Flow releases his huge other big thing in the coming year, which would probably be sometime next year. Next up, we have some bad news or some good news, whichever way you want to take a look at it, on the PS3. The PS3 exploit, yes, the team who consists of XCourtDo and other people, the one I call Mr. E, apparently the PS3 exploit V3 has been leaked. Unfortunately, this means that people will be trying it on the PS3s even though it is unfinished. XCourtDo and his team actually already said that this is a highly brickable exploit right now because since it is not finished, and yeah, I would just highly recommend you not look for it and just wait until the full thing comes out. Last up is gonna be the PlayStation 4. We got a new official firmware out, and it's official firmware 5.50. It brings cool features such as being able to hide apps and icons on the main menu, as well as able to view your playtime records and more. But there's also another thing for the homebrew developers and everything out there. The 5.02 WebKit exploit still works on the 5.50. firmware. Yes, they did not patch it for some odd reason, but currently you can't actually use it all since, you know, it's only the WebKit exploit. We're still waiting for a kernel exploit to be released, so we can't actually put the whole thing together and have a full-fledged working exploit on 5.50 or 5.02, whichever you want. Again guys, just because you're on 5.02 does not mean you should update to 5.50 because there's still more vulnerabilities in the lower firmwares, so don't update. Last week we talked about the popular PS4HEN exploit that was on 4.05 and then people exploited over to 4.07. I know I have those numbers wrong. I know I do. People have started to make it actually open source, so now the Holy Grail exploit that you have essentially is a PS4HEN exploit, but it is not open source. Now we do have an open source one, meaning we have more options to choose from and also more ways to customize it. And one such customization adds the fact that you can install PKG files onto a USB drive. Yes, you'll be able to install all your games onto a USB drive eventually. Currently, you can only use one game per USB drive, which really does not seem suitable at all, but I am sure in the future you'll be able to do more with it. And last but not least, the popular developer Dean K, the one who made Multiman for PS3, he will be porting over Multiman onto the PS4. Currently he is working on it, and that is some great, great news, because with all the features that Multiman has, such as, you know, Webman, S-Man, and everything else, I am happy to see a very, very popular developer porting over stuff to the PS4. I'm sure it will have all the same features and things like that, and currently All we know is that he is actually working on it. We don't have any release date or anything like that. So just be patient, guys, and I'm sure when it releases, it's gonna be awesome. And with that said, guys, that is everything, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that like and subscribe button, as well as that little bell icon so you don't miss any of my videos, and I will see you all next video.